The idea is very simple. You just either take a photograph or find an image to start, and you send that to another player of the game, and they alter it, they montage it, or they change it in some way, and then they send it back to you, and you do another version, you put montage on top, you change it in some way, and send it back to them. So it ping-pongs between the two players back and forwards. The whole thing is that the students are learning how to use the software without it being a sort of like a step-by-step, arduous sort of session. They're playing a game, so they've got that eager anticipation of what the other player will do to the image. And that sort of spurs the whole process on and also makes it really good fun. For teachers would be to have a go playing a game or two with another teacher before you present it to a class so that you can get some ideas there, and also so that you've got some sort of introduction to show your students. Or perhaps get some of your older students to play some games that they can then introduce to younger students. I've played this game a lot with groups where we've twinned with classrooms across the other side of the world and sent the images back and forth through the ether from England to California to Sydney to the Middle East, schools and other cultures, which is really good fun. My top tip for this is just to do it, because it just works. It's really good fun. It's learning without learning, because you've got that added element of the game.